What's up, Crosspoint kids? I hope you're having a great week. I hope your day is off to a great start, and I hope you are ready to learn about Jesus today. Let's kick things off by worshiping Him together. Let's get on our feet. We're gonna sing, we're gonna dance. Let's give Him the praise that He deserves.
You made the sky above, you made the oceans deep.
We want to thank you, Heavenly Father, for this new day that you've given us. We thank you for your creativity, as we're going to learn about and talk today about how creative you are in so many ways, and how we just need to look around us and see the amazing things you've made for us, and that includes us as human beings, God. Thank you for making us. Thank you for giving us a mind that we can learn with and get to know you better with. Thank you for blessing us to be created in your image. And God, help us to understand today that we can work together. We can be creative by working together for your good, Lord. We thank you. We honor you today, God. In your holy name we pray. Amen. All right, Crosspoint kids, so good to be here with you right now. I miss you so much, those of you who haven't been here at church, but we just want you to know that we love you, and we can't wait to be with you again soon and just all be together here in God's house. Today we are continuing to learn about creativity and how God uses that creativity for our benefit. We are defining creativity as imagining what you could do because you're made in God's image. And our theme is indescribable. Your Creator has no limits. So when we think about creativity, things that often come to mind are being a really good artist, or maybe a musician playing an instrument, being a good singer. Maybe it's getting on stage and being a performer in a play or a dancer. These are all great things. But creativity is so much more than that. You see, God created each one of us to be unique and to have certain gifts. We are alone the only people that's ever been like us. There's nobody else that's ever walked this earth that is just like you. And that is what makes you creative. That's what makes you unique. And God wants us to identify those gifts that He has given us. It could be the creativity of organizing or supporting a friend or just being there for somebody in your life. That is what God calls us to do, and that is what can make you creative. Finding little moments throughout your life to do things for somebody else, that's creativity, along with being a good painter, a good dancer, a good musician. Let's take a look at our memory verse this month. It comes to us from the book of Psalms, Psalm 145, verse 3, and that verse is, "Great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. His greatness no one can fathom." So for today's story, we are going to be in the book of Mark, chapter 2, verses 1 through 12. This is going to be while Jesus was traveling around teaching and performing miracles. Today we find him in a town called Capernaum. And while he was there, there was a group of men who worked together to help their friend. This is an awesome story of how they used their creativity together to do something amazing. And Jesus also, believe it or not, did something amazing. So let's watch this story video today. Go ahead and open your Bibles again to the book of Mark, chapter 2, verses 1 through 12. Then we're going to come back and we're going to talk about this lesson.
Inspired by the book of Mark, chapter 2, verses 1 through 12.
Jesus began teaching and healing in Galilee. He had become so popular that a whole mob of people would show up whenever he entered a town.
Oh, my tummy hurts.
My donkey has bad breath.
Tell me how to get rich quick in my spare time working from home.
For a time, Jesus stayed out of the towns in lonely places, but even then people came to him. So he returned to the town of Capernaum, and word of his arrival spread like wildfire.
Stop what you're doing! Jesus is back!
Yep, everybody heard the news. Even a man we'll call, Bo.
He's here! In Capernaum!
But Bo couldn't just hop up and see Jesus. In fact, he lay on a mat every single day, unable to walk a single step. So his four friends will all huddle together.
You think Jesus could help him?
Well, sure.
How do we get him up there?
We've got arms, we've got legs, we'll carry him.
So the four friends each took a hold of a corner of the mat and carried Bo directly through town to the home where Jesus was staying. By the time they arrived at the house, they saw everyone in town crowded inside and jammed around the windows and doors outside. Bo could see nothing but a tangle of legs.
Guys?
There's no way to get inside.
I know. Bo can crowd surf into Jesus.
That's one idea.
Or I could tie a couple of foxes together, set their tails on fire, and let them loose to make a pathway inside.
That's also an idea.
We could try the roof.
Bo?
The roof?
We're not turning back now.
So together, the four friends carried Bo on his mat up the narrow stairs that led to the roof. They could hear Jesus' voice below filtering through the clay roof tiles.
God's kingdom is like a mustard seed, which is the smallest of all seeds. But when you plant the seed, it becomes the largest of all.
Guys, how does coming up here help?
We're closer to Jesus.
He's right beneath us.
Hey, are you thinking what I'm thinking?
It's time to raise the roof.
Working together, the four friends shifted the heavy tiles until they made a hole in the roof. Below, they could see Jesus, along with a crowd of confused religious leaders, teachers, and townspeople.
The sky is falling!
Time to move it.
Using ropes, the four friends picked up Bo's mat again and slowly lowered him down through the hole in the roof.
And I'm free, free falling. No!
Don't worry, we got you, Bo.
Everyone below scrambled to get out of the way as Bo's mat came to rest on the floor right in front of Jesus.
Hi?
It seemed as though everyone in the room held their breath as Jesus looked up to see the four friends peering down from the hole in the roof. Jesus could see the deep faith that had led them to bring their friend to him. Then Jesus looked down at Bo and smiled.
Son, your sins are forgiven.
The religious leaders were shocked. Though no one said a word, they were practically screaming inside their heads.
What? That's evil. Only God can forgive sins.
Jesus knew exactly what they were thinking. If Jesus could forgive sins, he was claiming to be God.
Why are you thinking these things? Is it easier to say to this man, your sins are forgiven? Or to say, get up, take your mat, and walk?
Fat chance of that.
But I want you to know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins.
From above, Fred, Mary, Pip, and Sam all watched in fascination as Jesus turned back to Bo.
Get up, take your mat, and go home.
Every eye in the room turned from Jesus to Bo. For the tiniest moment, Bo hesitated. Then, he sat up. With growing confidence, he swung his legs around. And then, he scrambled up to his feet. Up above, his friends cheered.
Huzzah!
Oh, you go, Bo!
Bo took a step. A hop. A leap!
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
As the crowd watched in amazement, Bo picked up his mat and danced right out of that house. People moved aside faster than if Bo had been a fox with its tail on fire.
I've never seen anything like it.
Well, bless his heart and praise the Lord.
Bo had been healed by the power of God and because his friends had worked together to help bring him to Jesus.
Jesus showed everybody in that crowded house in Capernaum just how powerful he is. He showed them that he has the ability to heal a man who cannot walk. And he showed them that he can forgive sins. Think about the creativity it took for that group of friends, those four men, to get their paralyzed friend in front of Jesus. It must have been would have been easy for them to just turn around and go the other way when they saw the crowd in front of them. But instead, they used their creativity to bring that mat with their friend on it up to the roof, cut a hole in it, and drop him down to be in front of Jesus. And as we learn in this story today, Jesus saw that. He appreciated that. He saw their faithfulness and their dedication to want to see him, and he rewarded them for it. You see, just like these four men in the story today, Jesus calls us to work together to be creative. That's why our bottom line today is God created you to work with others. God made each of us in his own image, and he gave us each gifts that are unique to ourselves. He wants us to use those together with our friends and the people around us so that we can do good works. The Bible doesn't tell us exactly the steps that were taken to get this man into the house. It doesn't tell us which friend did what when. But I can imagine that it was probably one person's idea to get this man up on the roof. I'm guessing one or two of these men were probably stronger than the others, and they were the ones that did the heavy lifting to get the mat up there. My guess is one of them probably was best with a handsaw, and they were the one that cut through the roof to get the man down. You see, it was a collective effort, and it needed all four of them, all of them to work together to get this done. If it was just one or even two of them, I doubt they would have been able to get the paralyzed friend inside the house. But together they could do it. And because of it, this story is in the Bible. You see, you can do the same thing. Maybe you have a neighbor down the street who needs some help. Maybe he or she could use some help raking leaves this fall, or they need some help watching a couple of their young kids. And maybe this is something that you can't do by yourself, but if you gather a couple of friends, some neighbors around you, you can go over there together and lend a helping hand. That would make a big difference in their life. Or maybe I'll use the example again of there's somebody in your class or here at church or anywhere else in life that you think might be lonely and could use a group of friends to come around them. And maybe you alone are intimidated by the idea of walking up to him or her and saying, "Hey, do you want to be my friend?" But if you have a couple of friends already, what if you went together to this person and you said, "Hey, come join us. You can hang out with us." That makes it a little bit easier on you, doesn't it? And it'll really make a difference in their life. You see, God calls us to work together. He calls us to share ideas with one another. We can't do it all by ourselves. But when we have good friends around us, fellow Jesus followers, that are willing to work together, it's amazing the things that can get done for God's benefit. He wants to use you, and he wants to use you together with somebody in your life. So ask him to point you in that direction. Ask him, say, "God, I'm not sure right now what it is that you want me to do, but help me understand who the people in my life are that I can work with." Maybe you're a Boy Scout or a Girl Scout. I remember when I was a Boy Scout, when I was a kid, I was in Boy Scouts for many years, and it felt like everything we did together. Everything was team-oriented, building ropes courses, building things together, figuring out how to start a fire together. Everything we would do was together. And it was amazing the things that we could accomplish as a group. We've played games and activities here in Crosspoint Kids, and if you notice, almost everything that we do is together in a group. Our memory verse relay races, our Jenga building tower competitions, our trivia nights, everything that we do is in a group. God wants us to work together. We're better together. We can do more good together. So I encourage you, identify some people in your life that you can come around. You might have a friend right now as a 6, 7, 8, 9-year-old. You might have a friend that you're friends with for the rest of your life. I'm 33, and some of my best friends I've known since I was your age, and we do things together still. God calls us to identify those people in our lives. that we can be with, that we can be creative with, and do good works with. Let's give the Lord some praise right now for giving us the ability to be creative, giving us the chance to come around our friends and our family with others, and to do good works. Let's give Him some praise right now. Dear God, you have given us so many unique talents, so much creativity. God, we pray that we're able to identify it. Help us, Lord, to not focus on what we can't do. Help us to not focus on what we're not good at. That's so easy to do sometimes, Lord. Help us instead to focus on what you created us to do. Help us to ask ourselves, what do we enjoy? What are we good at? I think, God, when we find the answers to those questions, oftentimes we can find our purpose. And God, we ask that we use our creativity with the people around us for your benefit. Just like these four friends in the story today, help us to do good works with the people around us like you call us to do. Help us to come together in unity. Help us to break down any barriers that might be between us, that might be keeping us from being together, Lord. Help us to just find ourselves, find our group of people. Help us to come alongside each other. Help us to not leave anybody out. Help us to include everyone. Lord God, we thank you for the ability to work together. We thank you for friendships. We thank you for family. We thank you for our creativity, Lord. Thank you for making us just the way we are. In your holy name we pray, Jesus. Amen. Okay, Crosspoint kids, it's been so good being with you today. I look forward to talking to you soon. I look forward to seeing you soon. Have a great week. I love you.